Hi guys, and welcome to my new video. I'm the creator of the game called Snappy Mouse Run, and in this video I will show you how you can set up your background and reference images in Blender 2.8 for 3D modeling. And let's get right into it. First we need to adjust the shading, and we'll do this by pressing this transparent icon over here, or just press Alt-Z on your keyboard. You see the object gets transparent, and then we'll switch to wireframe view, that's this icon over here, or just press Z on your keyboard and select wireframe. Next we'll go to the shading drop down and set the x-ray to 0 so we can see right through the object completely. Next, we'll split the view into three viewports. The first will be the front view, the second the side view, and the third will be the top view. You can do this by going with your mouse to the lower left corner of the viewport. You will see this plus sign pops up. Then press the left mouse key and just drag it into the view. Now we have two views, and do this once again. Now we have three views. So this is the front view, this will be our side view, and this will be our top view. Let's adjust those views now. Go to the first view, press 1 on your numpad, and go to the add menu, or press Shift A and select image reference, and select your front reference image, load reference. You see the image is in the front view, and you'll also see the new image here in the outlier. So let's name the image front. Do this again for the second view. Press 3 on your numpad. This is the side perspective. Then again, Shift A. And what's pretty handy, Blender has remembered what we selected last time, so the image is pre-selected. That's pretty handy. You can't do this by pressing the add menu, only by using the shortcuts, for instance Shift A, and select reference, then go to select the side reference, load reference. You see this is the side picture in the side view. Also the image is in the outlier, let's name it side. Then again in the top view, press 7 on your numpad, that's the top perspective. Then Shift A, image reference, and select the top reference image. Okay, we have now loaded our images into the views. And again, call the image top. What I like to do is to group the images into a new collection. So let's press right mouse button in the outlier, select new, and we created a new collection. Let's call the collection reference, for instance, reference. Okay, just select the images and drag them into the reference collection, and deselect the viewport selection. So what this does, you cannot select the images in the viewport, but you can select the images in the outlier. Next thing we want to do, we want to adjust the reference images so the 3D object, in this case the cube, fits the object on the background image. And what I mean by this will be clear in a moment. Let's just make sure that the front image is selected in the outlier. Again, we cannot select it in the viewport because this one is disabled, so go to the outlier. Then go to Object Data tab, that's this one over here. And you know this is Object Data because it has the same image as the selected object in the outlier. So if we switch, for instance, to the cube, by selecting the cube, you see the Object Data has a new image, and that's this one over here. If you're new to Blender, this is what Blender does, and you need to get used to it. So let's switch to our front reference image, go to Object Data, and adjust the front view image. And we will do this by changing the properties in the Object Data, for instance the size and the X and Y offset. If you are confused by the 5 meters here, by the unit meter, you can simply turn that off by going to the Scene tab and go to Units and just Unit System, switch this to None. If you go back to object data, then you see no units anymore. Okay, now let's scale the image. Okay, I have adjusted the front reference image. So the object on the image fits the 3D object. In our case, this is our cube. That's it. Now let's do this for the second, for the side view. Here we need to consider one thing, and that's the height of the object. You see the height is on the Z axis and points up. Here also the height points up. It's the also the Z axis. And we need somehow get the size match this size over here. Okay, we adjusted our second side view, and now let's get to the top view. In the top view, you need to consider two things, and this is the width of the object, and it's on the X axis. That's this axis over here, you see X, and the length of the object, and that's on the Y axis. That's this axis over here, y-axis. And also what you need to consider is where the y-axis is pointing. In this case, you see the handle of the object on the image is pointing in the y-axis direction. So you need to check this here. Also here, you see the handle on the object is pointing also in the Y direction, and that's very important, because if the image is pointing some other direction, we need to rotate the image. You can't do this in this properties right here in the object data. You need to do it on the image itself. So we would need to select the image, and let's do this right now. Let's enable the selection in the viewport, select the image. So that's our top image right now selected. And then press R on your keyboard, and for instance on your numpad press 180, and the image is now upside down. But in this case we don't want this, because the image is pointing in the right direction, so we will leave it as it is. Let's just disable the viewport selection. Again, top view, reference image, and let's adjust it. Okay, we have adjusted our top view image, and with this our setup is complete. The next step would be to model this object on the background image. Okay, thank you for joining me, and if you want more content like this, just give a like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!